Today, we want to introduce a very simple use of Active RFID in commercial application. You only need one such Active RFID reader and then insert it into the Raspberry Pi to start experiencing the fastest software setup within 10 minutes. The following shows how to carry out the implementation. This is our standard 2.4 GHz Active RFID reader that can read the ID or sensor transponder from Hong Kong RFID Limited, tags such as NT02, TT02, and RT02. This reader itself has no advanced processor, like it has no brain at all, so it simply outputs the information whatever it received from transponder. Any further tasks require a PC or server, and this will set restrictions in applications. Not to mention the programming efforts to write an application. But now, we have found a very simple way, i.e. to add a small computer, Raspberry Pi. This small computer Raspberry Pi itself comes with many expandable interfaces, such as a USB interface, network cable port, HDMI, and SD card slot. If you plug in a network card, you can directly access the wireless network. Via the HDMI interface, information may be output to a TV. If you insert a SD card in the SD slot, the system can have a storage capacity as the SD card and can back up the data too. We can easily write some applications in it, and if you connect this little computer Raspberry Pi to the network, your applications can be implemented immediately. Then, how to operate it? Let's see details below. Step 1. Connect the reader to the Raspberry Pi. Step 2. Connect the Raspberry Pi to the network. Step 3. Enter an appropriate IP, the web is connected with the Raspberry Pi. It's that simple, isn't it? These are set in the Raspberry Pi because it itself is a computer. Currently, because of the connection of the Raspberry Pi, you can easily manage your tags through this page and can easily know which tag almost run out of a battery, which tag represents which contents, and so on. These applications are very simple and can be directly settled in the Raspberry Pi by very simple steps. Once set up, you will not just get a demonstration device, but a real applicable system. Because a Raspberry Pi can connect more than one reader, it is quick and convenient for the implementation of small projects. Furthermore, during actual implementation, you need to consider the coverage of the antenna. You can place the tag to where you want it to be read or must be detected or must not be detected, where it will produce corresponding sensitivity data. Referring to this sensitivity data to set the scope of coverage you want can be simple and convenient. Hong Kong RFID Limited gives a unique identification number for each tag, but for an application, it may match a manually specified number or property number. Then, what applications does it have? Here basically lists all the applications. Each application is required to purchase its license. Now, I will briefly describe the licenses. The first application is the Signage Trigger. If the TV is connected to a Raspberry Pi, the reader will read an ID and then the corresponding multimedia contents such as pictures, video, and other audio and video contents almost in every format can be displayed through HDMI. The second application is the anti-theft. You can make a design, that is, if there are objects or people going through a specific zone, it will trigger the alarm. Of course, you can also set the length of the alarm and whether you need to follow up the alarm by email. The third application is the attendance. Attendance is for work or school attendance management. The system will automatically log the in-time and out-time. Also, email or short messages for alert is available here for late or absence. The fourth application is the sensor data. When a large number of sensor data is processed, charts can be generated by setting off the Raspberry Pi, and can also set fixed thresholds, such as giving out an alarm when the temperature exceeds a certain limit. Another application is the inventory asset. This application is a sample management system that is suitable for IT, medical equipment, expensive items, or audio equipment. For large items that may be frequently rent out and returned, the use of Active RFID can automatically record these times. an unauthorized removal of items will trigger an alarm too. Or if some items are missing when taking inventory, it can identify which items have not been read or which items have been read. Finally, the next application is access control. For cases when someone enters a forbidden area, you can also set an alert. After accessing to the network, you can see some basic settings. In the basic menu, IP setting is to set the IP of the Raspberry Pi or the readers. Date and time is to set the time and date. Device manager is to manage multiple devices. With the use of Wi-Fi, a Raspberry Pi can manage multiple readers. Data log and delivery can set how the data are recorded and their input and output in your preset schedule. In calibration, it provides a very simple implementation method. In the ID tag menu, you can manage your ID. Generally, hundreds of ID tags will be used together in reality, so it is hard to manage these ID tags. In the ID tag, you can upload the corresponding number of property and personal numbers data to the system, and then the system is defined on the basis of list numbers in subsequent applications. This can help you manage a large number of tags. We also have other functions, such as debugging, administration, login, or license settings. We are also providing after-sales support. This set of systems is already in development, and customers' comments are appreciated.